DWE.
Me and Generals, yeah, Dirty Stanks the label, you're watching Westwood TV, we're here!
Yo, Walk One, is D Double. Right now, this is DJ Mag, yeah? Meet the MC, and you're meeting me? Jesus! Let me score ya.
D-Double is the greatest of all time. Can we not all agree with that?
I've been spitting on radio, freestyling, giving people all my lyrics. You can't actually listen to it. You had to kind of be there, or you could record it yourself.
Where that blue building is, that's where Rinse FM was. Just like now, you can't actually see a door. Back in the day, we had to actually climb up over the wall. A certain man fell, but these were the risks we took to get on radio. We treated it like it was in our mate's bedroom because we got the phone line, but still, when we're on the street, no one knows who we are. We're just normal guys, just like, so we're doing a lot, but we couldn't get it back. So to know that we got it, I got it back later on in life, performing and everyone singing back all the work that I put out, it was good to see over the years.
Yo, I spent 64, hot like tar, shoot me a star, get very far, never let the go away, I'm in the sky, top of these niggas don't know if they're going to talk like this, make your move, it's going to be over,
it's now when I look back, it was a risk, but it wasn't a risk then to want to be on the mic. It was a risk for the person that's made this radio station situation. If police had turned up, we would think we're innocent. It's only when the police did come, you actually felt like, whoa, a certain man would run, and then you'd feel funny. But in general, I thought it was legal before it was. A lot of the early jungle DJs, we all wanted to be on Cool FM, but we couldn't get on there. We found other stations that we could be on. Just listening to jungle sets and doing jungle sets. That's all, that's my early memories. I was in a crew called Reckless Crew, Terror Danger, Triple Threat, and it used to be jungle, man, like, 20 miles an hour, just going crazy. Still with the first moments of this place. And I started turning up at radio with the biggest book. So then I'm spitting bars, and then when I give the mic, I'm just going to my book and I'm next page, and I'm like, all right. And then I wait for the mic, and then after a while, I felt a bit silly bringing in a book. And I thought, you know what, I don't want to be flicking a book. I need to just get back on it again and just make sure that I know what I'm saying.
But don't get prang or get dang, cause my lyrical style is nang. Don't get brave, think of a dang, can't none of you, man, can't do me a fan, can't man when the teeth and jack my...
I tried to put some of those lyrics on tunes back in the day. Cause people knew the lyrics so well, it didn't really make sense because people wanted to hear a tune with new lyrics and it was the same lyrics. So then in my head I thought, bruh, if I never spat a bar on radio and every one of my lyrics, I went to the studio, put them down and made projects, I would be a different guy today.
Listen, it's not long, it's very quick. Listen, it's D-Double, still the lick. Yo. Listen, I only deal with original written. That's why man like me's getting bitten. Pure MC's wanna be my petition. Well listen, we brought you on the long mission. Been a lyrically dance since when I was christened. From 13 I had a lyrically vision. Spent time in the studio just like prison. Now I'm armed to the teeth with the lyric ammunition.
It was a fun album to record, I can't lie man. When I was recording it, most of it I didn't vision any collaborations. I was just concentrating on what I liked. So each beat that I got, it's like I really liked the beat. I sat down and listened to what I'd done, and then that's when I pictured who I wanted to get on it if I did put someone on it.
What's going on? It's Raskin, yeah? Dizzy Rascal, Dirty Stankin', Newham Generals here on Westwood TV, yeah?
Come on, come on. It's overly warm. The heat keeps man overly warm in a war. Man, we're overly storm in the night time with a couple nines and a song. Don't watch me, rude boy, watch porn. Don't wanna see your jewelry get pawned in front of the wifey and the newborn. Don't wanna get laid out on the lawn, get found in the morn. If you're next on the list, then it's warm. Stay in the yard with your curtains drawn, cause you never know when the man them are gonna storm. Just know that the man them never inform.
Yeah, this is a place that I used to come here after school. I used to play in this little area at 7 o'clock. There was like a basketball session. So I used to go home, get changed and then come back. When I used to come here, there used to be other schools. So when I used to come here, there'd be a few girls as well, you get me? This is like a quite important time of a crossover period from loving basketball and loving music at the same time and kind of being involved in music. So we used to do little freestyles, all the things kids do, man, just beatboxing, a cappella. It wasn't serious, it was like all of us just trying to make each other laugh.
Come on, Rob William and take that. Yeah. Man can't tell me a thing about rap, man. Man can't tell me a thing about Robin. Man can't tell me a thing about Lucky. Man can't tell me a thing about dodging. Man can't tell me a thing about pain. Man can't tell me a thing about sad. Man can't tell me a thing about good. Man can't tell me a thing about bad. Man can't tell me a thing about youths. Man can't tell me a thing about younger. Man can't tell me a thing about hustling. Man can't tell me a thing about hunger. Just know man will cheese
up. I was just talking to someone the other day, it's hard to chill out, man. I'll just see something and I'll start thinking, well, that's what we need to do. It's like I come up with my new ideas, man. My major thing chilling is watching the documentary. There's one thing, what's it called? The Octopus, well, some man who's got this lake near his yard, went there, he goes fish, he goes swimming, diving in there actually. And then there's this octopus, and he knows where he is every day. And when he comes, the octopus hides. And then after, it showed 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 2 months, and it shows him go there. Next thing you know, the octopus is coming out. Next thing you know, they end up being brethren, bro, swimming together, all sorts of stuff, you get me? And I was watching that and I was just thinking, nah, is he mad? Oh, am I mad?
Lyrical incredible Hulk. I get money and I get it in bulk. Make an MC go home and talk. Them man can't show me the ropes, can I? Them man can't show me the ropes. Them man lit on a slippery slope. Them man there must think it's a joke. Them man are snorting too much coke.
D-Double to me is godly. Because when you think about his delivery, his style, like his impact, bro, his impact at that time when he cut through was crazy.
OE3, bringing back a lot of memories right now. So when I used to come and visit my dad and my brother and sister and the family, this was like the area. Going little walkies, go through there, at least to Roman Road Market, get up to a lot of shit. Yeah, there used to be a lot of fights as well, man. Troublemakers. But mainly a lot of community togetherness around this area, man. I kind of grew up in a lot of different areas. I'm from Forest Gate. I grew up here, and I also grew up in Leytonstone too. I was actually going to some house parties where I need to ask my mum, can I go to the party? And she'd be like, where is it? And then I get there, and it's a house party, and it's like sick. So yeah, they were that in my early teens, like picking up the mic, and then my friend saying, there's a party in East Ham. And I won't even know whose party it is. And then I'll be like, cool, let's go. Then I'll end up at someone else's house party, you know them ones. Yeah, so this is basically the area now where my dad used to live, yeah? Basically here. Let's take a walk, man. Used to play football on this little green little bit here. Used to do some fake little athletics thing where we used to just run around there 3-4 times so you can get the best time and all them things there. You get me? Couple of man used to try and get involved, couple neighbours, couple young man on the block. My dad never really had no interaction at that time in terms of music. I remember one time he saw I had some lyrics in a bag or something and they fell out. And the old school books, pieces of paper, lyrics. And my dad was like, "Raw, what's this?" And I was like, "It's lyrics." And he was like, "Raw," he was like, "What?" And then now, he's the first one to mention it to other people now. You know, them ones there, he's like, "Well, you know, my son." He's not a man that's listening to my music though. He doesn't know I got an album out. Even if you told him, he might forget. My mum was, she didn't really understand it. She used to connect it more to doing the wrong thing, like just being with a gang or more of a street vibe or just getting up to nothing. She never used to put up barriers or nothing. She just used to make sure I was not forgetting real life, part of my mum's way to get me focused. She hooked me up with my aunt, and my aunt was an accountant at South Kensington University. And she employed me for 6 months. I had to put on a suit and tie, go there and do some mad professional work, you get me? So I got them skills there. I know my mathematics and my calculations. And I gave up working when the music didn't give me enough time and was giving me the money. So I made the right transition at the right time. Naturally, yeah, that's where the more progression come in terms of my dress sense, when I was shopping, used to been buying gold jewelry from young and just been able to do things. Personally, like being Jamaican is a big part of me too. My whole style is developed from it more than hip-hop. Without me knowing, that is my main inspiration of my flow and how my stage presence and how I dress sometimes and just how I move.
Trust me, big up the East coming side. Big up boys in the hood. Big up Road D. It's ramming here, trust me.
When I was growing up and I used to listen to you,
yeah,
that's what I got a sense of. You had a bit of your own character though. You stood out because you had a bit of your own character. But you said, I listened to you lot because you lot sounded like where I was from. Jungle MCs and Garage MCs.
Right.
Chatting to Mike, I make you say, call blimey, that boy's got wicked style. What's his name? D.E.E. Best MC in the industry. Chatting to Mike, I make you say, call. That boy's got lyrics galore. A little bit of jungle. Like, that stuff. You know what I mean? That's what I grew up to when I sat and listened to pirate radio.
Where we are now used to be like a youth centre that my uncle used to work at. He used to spend a lot of my 6 weeks holiday coming here. So he used to bring us here, me and my cousin, and we used to come here during the 6 weeks holiday. It used to be sick vibes. I gained a lot of connections without even knowing it. Growing up with certain people that I wouldn't have. Connections is always around. Everyone's got connections. It's just how good are you at communicating with everyone, and that's it, simple. If Wiley's dad and my dad and Footsie's dad and Kano's dad, if they actually met up, they will tell you that we know each other, we're friends. We used to go to this pub, we used to go there. My uncle used to be friends with Crazy Titch's dad, and Marcus Nasty and Matt Ten's dad was friends with this one's dad. It's the connections was already there. It's just the area, man. It's just like having a big school and everybody's young, playing around, and then you all grow up and move in different areas, but it's the same energy. Yeah, it's just a generation. I was trying to go hard on the breakdancing thing at this time, yeah. There was a dance competition with other youth centres maybe, or anyway, I was representing this youth centre. Had a lot of determination. Whatever I'd done, I tried to do it the best. And we went to a competition and we won the competition. And I remember being in the local North London newspaper and my picture was in there, mid dance moves. And that was the first time I saw myself in a paper. To have family is a good thing. Big or small, but tight. As long as you've got family, it's good. I've been going crazy on production for the past, I'd say, 3 years maybe now. 2020 was the year I thought I want to push my production a lot more harder. I produced the beat for Trouble featuring Triggs and 24/7 solo track, and I produced it by myself. I made them by myself. And I'm looking forward to dropping some more. I've got some more surprises coming production-wise. Ablibs are serious, man. They're serious things, man. The background, the atmosphere, is the energy, the topping, man. That salt bait is the...
Ooh, ooh! Dirty T. That's Mri.
It's natural for me as well. So when I'm listening to songs, I'm ablibbing in the car. We could be just listening to anyone right now and I'll be just sticking in my 2p. Because it's just natural for me to back up. Yeah, when Footsie was on stage, the way I used to back him up, he used to back me up hard, hard. Yeah, ad-libs is serious for me. So for me, it's just say something. Totally. But it's the way I said it. It's the way I say it, oh my gosh. Or you could just say, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it's just, I just got this ring on what I say and it just always works, man.
Oh my gosh. It's D-Double. Old type swerve on production. It's street fighting time.
Round one, fight!
If it's me, you're mad at. You get a scar on your chest like Saka. Street fighting, that's what I'm bad at. My thing working.
Perfect.
I come through in the beat up on the give man a hundred slaps like Yonder. Give me the mic and let me ride it with them, cause I spit the fire just like now them. I'm a Liverpool invader, climbing to the top just like Vega. You be me, nobody can save ya. On the mic, I'm way too major. Cause I'm shocking MCs like Blanca. I got money in the bank, I'm a banker. You ain't got money in your bank, you're a wanker. My word. I want the gallimer set. I want the champion there. With the lardy dardy, we likes to party. Where's that rum? Where's the Bacardi? Where's that Red Bull? Where's that brandy? Vodka, it's gonna come in handy. Gallimer got man feeling randy. Feel it up right to the top. Could've been a Grey Goose or the Ciroc. Right about now I'm feeling tipsy. Could it be the Hennessy? Could it be the whiskey? I don't know, cause my memory's misty. Having a laugh, having a bubble, nah. I don't want no trouble. All I want is a drink on the double. Make it a double for me, D-Double. Tonight, we're on a hype. It's your rambler, don't be shy. Can the gala get drunk on a rosé, rosé? Gala get drunk on a rosé wine. Can't be sleeping, it's not that time. Show me a signal, show me a sign. Gotta go get a wine from behind. Gotta go get a wine to the beeline. Don't touch that bottle right there, that's mine. Tequila, Zambuca, got me feeling super duper. Banging a wall and I'm tooting a hooter. I'm on the dance floor working it out. What happened last night, still working it out. Now I got this ting, Italiano says I'm the one. Like Keanu, back to the hotel with the Serrano. With the bop. Ooh, ooh. Dirty T. That's me. Yeah, I'm chilling by the bar. Chilling by the bar. I see this sexy princess and I see her. Had to make my move. Find out who you are, cause girl, you're looking like a star. Looking like a ooh, ooh. Bloco. In a DM farmer head. Bloco, bloco, boss. I shot in a DM farmer leg. Running things when I'm in the chat or not. Bloco, bloco. It's D double. Over and out. Cheese.